Friends, hello, welcome back. Today we take a look back at Big Z, aka Zdeno Chara's 20 plus year career, something that you do not see too often in any sport, let alone from a defenseman in the NHL who usually doesn't even come into the league until they're in their early 20s, to say the least. So Zdeno Chara has been quite the defenseman over the years. He's played for three separate teams, and for that reason, you know he's played with a lot of talented players. And in today's video, we're gonna go and show you a team of all former Zdeno Chara teammates. Former teammates only. I just realized we could have done teammates in general here, but we've been doing former teammates with this theme of the video, so we're gonna stick with that. And there's a lot of solid players in here. We'll take a peek at it real quick here. We already seen a teaser in Jágr, but we have Jágr, Bill Kessel, and Tyler Seguin on that first line there. A pretty filthy first line, to say the least, there, Boston. All Boston guys. Jágr was even a Boston guy, right? All former Boston players there. If I ain't mistaken, Jágr played for like 18 different leagues, actually. So I'm pretty sure Boston was probably one of them. Blake Wheeler, another guy there. Boston, Bruin, great. But Jágr also played for like half the Metro. And when, you know, Zdeno was on the Islanders, good chance he was there too. Now, it's not ringing a bell which one it was. And it's not letting me look at his career stats for some reason. Season stats, preseason stats. Maybe he's never played in the NHL before. It's possible. I doubt it, but it's possible. Trevor Linden on that second line with Marian Hossa as well. Alfredson, Daniel Tyke, third line with Olli Jokinen and Mark Recchi. Recchi again. What team build doesn't Recchi make? We need to do a team of former, what's the word we're looking for? We'll get it. A team of all former, no, we won't get it. A team of all Mark Recchi former teammates. That's what we got to do. I feel like this guy's played with, I feel like you have an entire team of Hall of Famers. He's literally, he's playing with everybody. Every build we do, he's on here. But we got Heater, baby. Danny Healy had to make the team. Even give him a nice 86 overall. Mark Savard in there. And we have Milan Lucic on the fourth line. Yeah, that is where it was there. On defense, we gave Zdeno the big 90. You know what? We're going to bring him back to all of his former teammates. We better bring him back to prime time Zdeno Chara, which might even be better than a 90 overall. But we'll give him a 90. Well, it probably is better than 90 overall. But we'll give him a 90 overall for the sake of the video here. Wade Redden, the D pair partner there with Roman Hamrlik. I can't say it. I can't. It's like trying to roll your R's. I could be completely botching that name too. Dougie Hamilton, and then Chris Phillips and Dennis Weidman there back in the Ottawa days was Chara on that third line there. And then the goaltending, pretty solid decor here as well. Or goaltending corps here as well. Tim Thomas, Marty Turco, can't go wrong there, but let's see if this group here can win themselves a Stanley Cup. It's a pretty stacked lineup there from the offensive side. Big Chara over there, the main man on defense, which, you know, when you think about it, it makes sense because he was being paid and he was expected to be the top line D-man on every one of these teams he was on. And there's not very many cases where you see, you know, two elite defensemen on the same team, which, you know, Boston's trying to do their best to make that happen right now, though. They got a pretty solid young D-core. A lot of the younger D-men on Boston now has kind of been the guys that didn't make this team. That would be some solid players to have onto this one right now. But nonetheless, Boston, solid to start the season. Is that even as good as they started the actual NHL season, though? 18-5. Man, did they have a great season going this season. If they would have finished that one out, it would have been an interesting one there. Still got a chance, though. There's a lot of rumors going back and forth right now about whether the season happens, whether it doesn't happen, whether they finish it, whether they don't finish it, whether there's playoffs, whether they're not playoffs. At the end of the day, I just always try to remind myself that it's, you know, there's not a lot going on in sports right now. So they're going to kind of post any and every story to go out there and talk about and, you know, kind of go in depth about certain situations and say this could happen, this could happen. End of the day, we just have to wait it out. You know, we're seeing like with the MLB right now going through you know, a negotiation phase with the MLB owners and the players on what they want to do for the season. Something like that might or probably ends up happening to an extent with the NHL. I'd have to assume when you see it go like that, right? I guess. So until we see stuff like that put on paper, who knows what they do there. But it's great to see we're starting to hear the talk of sports, you know, at least coming back. It might be a few months, but we're starting to hear it come back. Obviously, the safety of the players and everyone else is still a big priority, and that's going to be something that's, you know, plays a big factor into whether the sports come back or not. But it's still, it's nice to have a little bit of hope, though, right? Nice to see that things are starting to slowly, you know, potentially come back to normal here. But Boston going out there 57-17-8 this season. What a season. Tyler Seguin killing it, baby. That's my boy. 98 points, 98 out of Jágr as well, 80 out of Phil Kessel, decent, 77 out of Hossa. Where in the heck is Chara? Chara? Chara only, what? 30 some point, excuse me. That's Big Zdeno Chara we're talking about here. Power play specialist was even on the power play. 20 minutes, he should have been. Killed it. But right, though. Probably played some good hockey during the season. And by good, I mean he was a plus 57, second best on the team, only to his defensive pairing partner in Wade Redden. I guess he played with Wade Redden, pretty solid player there. I was over there saying he didn't play with a lot of elite defensemen back in the day, but he played with some good players as well there. Gotta be careful what we say there. I wasn't really trying to bash any of his former teammates by any stretch of the imagination. He's played with a lot of good players over the season or over the course of his career. But nonetheless, who led the league in goal or team in goals, actually? Nonetheless, it was 39 by Tyler Seguin, of course. How'd the goaltending look? How did the goaltending look? We're talking 9-11, and we're talking 9-05 out of Timmy Toms and Marty Turco. Can we get Tim Thomas, Stanley Cup playoff winning, Stanley Cup champion Tim Thomas here? If we do, it should be a walk in the park for the Boston Bruins. But right now, they find themselves down 1-0 to the Florida Panthers in the first round. But they are making a comeback. And, maybe not. It was making a comeback up 3-1. Going to a game 7 against these Florida Panthers, a team that is always tough to play in Sims. And they upset this absolutely stacked former teammates of Zdeno Chara team. Let's find out. The answer is yes. Oh, my. Oh, man. That team was filthy. That team was absolutely filthy. Best team in the league. And they got upset by the Florida Panthers in the first round. Incredible. The Caps going to take home the Stanley Cup. We're going to see if any of these former teammates of Zdeno Chara or Chara himself took home an award this season. I assume they took the Norris home. Him or Redden about had to with those plus minuses. Not a lot of points though for Chara, so that might be hurting him there from that standpoint. The Art Ross going to Tyler Seguin, the Memorial, same story. Seguin playing his heart out this season. Jágr probably helping him out there quite a bit. James Norris went to Erik Karlsson. So indeed, there was no Norris coming home to Boston this season, unfortunately, but Seguin taking care of business. He even got to Lindsay this season. Maurice Richard going to Ovechkin. As for this video, guys, if you enjoyed it, big thumbs up and subscribe is appreciated. If you're already subscribed, you guys know I love you. But otherwise, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you next time.